You talk sometimes about weak men.
Mm.
Why are weak men such a problem?
Well, weak people are a problem in general. And I don't mean physically weak. I mean cowardly, let's say, and deceitful, because I'm thinking it more in terms of moral weakness. Well, there's a variety of reasons. First of all, if you can't support your own weight, let's say, then someone else has to do it. And that's not good. If you don't pick a forthright and useful and noble pathway through life, then you'll become bitter and too hurt by the tragedy of existence. And then you tend to seek your revenge wherever you can get it. And that's not good. So it's a mistake on all fronts. It's not good for you. It's not good for your family. It's not good for the community. It's certainly not a good medium to long-term strategy, because life is very, very difficult and you have to be prepared for that.
So I tell my dad and he goes, "Well, I would love to see you get a woman pregnant." And I said, "Oh, no, no, no. She would be getting me pregnant." And then he said, "What, do you have a vagina now?" And I said, "Never say never."
I think there's a massive war on masculinity right now, but I think it's a war which has been going on for a very long time. I mean, you only need to look at like media headlines, for example. They say if a man wants to be fit and strong, he's suddenly right wing. They talk about gym bros being dumb and all this stuff. You're also now encouraging men to cry and to do all these emotional things. I think they're trying to make women more masculine and make men more feminine, but it's so toxic. If a man is brave and strong, suddenly that's toxic masculinity. If a man wants to provide for his family, that's toxic masculinity. When it comes to equality and wanting quotas, you never hear anything about plumbers, builders. No, you don't want more female builders.
Do you think that there's an intentional effort from the people at the top to make us weaker and ruin the family?
Oh, absolutely there is. Absolutely there is.
Why are they trying to do that? Like, and who's behind it?
Why are they trying to do that? It's the same reason they've always done it. For all of human history, if a civilization invaded enemy territory and took over their lands, they would kill all the fighting age males. Killing them was the easiest way to get rid of them. Now you can't just straight up kill all the men who might throw a revolution against you. But what you can do is you can pussify them. You can make them so weak, so dependent on porn, video games, you know, because you've crushed their hope of meeting a woman in the real world. You've crushed their hope of getting married and having a family and supporting them on one job and having a wife that's loyal and obedient. And so many men are at war with their partner, with their sexual partner, with the woman who they're supposed to love. That's their war. That's the war that they're engaged in. And they're so engaged that they can't look elsewhere.
But one thing I'm not getting, there's a big difference between letting people do something for themselves and saying men should be dangerous. By dangerous, that implies I should be ready to threaten someone, to hurt somebody.
No, you should be capable of it. But that doesn't mean you should use it. There's nothing to you otherwise. Like, if you're not a formidable force, there's no morality in your self-control. If you're incapable of violence, not being violent isn't a virtue. People who teach martial arts know this full well, right? If you learn a martial art, you learn to be dangerous, but simultaneously you learn to control it. Both of those come together. And the combination of that capacity for danger and the capacity for control is what brings about the virtue. Otherwise, you confuse weakness with moral virtue. I'm harmless, therefore I'm good. It's like, no, that isn't how it works. That isn't how it works at all. If you're harmless, you're just weak. And if you're weak, you're not going to be good. You can't be, because it takes strength to be good. It's very difficult to be good.